Saudi Arabian Prince Alwaleed bin Talal is probably the richest and most powerful global investor that most of America has never heard of. He is the fifth richest man in the world with an estimated net worth of $21 billion. Aside from a global portfolio of real estate and hotel holdings, he also has major stock investments. In fact, he is the biggest single foreign individual investor in the U.S. stock market. He owns about 5% of Citigroup and has major stakes in Time Warner, News Corp, Apple, Motorola, and many others. But some of those investments haven't done so well in the last few years, and the prince agreed to sit down with us here in Paris to talk about his holdings.
It's been a number of years since you've made a big stock purchase in the United States. I mean, the year 2000, I think you put $2 billion into 19 different companies, but you called it your millennium bug. But since then, you haven't. Why not?
Look, we always monitor the situation globally, not only in the United States, even Europe and our region, Middle East, and the Far East. We always take an opportunistic approach. Whenever an opportunity arises, we invest, and we invest very swiftly. Our latest concentration has been the hotel industry. There has been a lot of movement, for example, selling the Plaza and re-entering the Plaza with a smaller stake, buying the Savoy, and buying scattered hotels in the internationally. But if you add all these, they count above the $2 billion range, but they have not been done in one transaction. And that's why they have not hit the headlines the way media likes them to.
Should we take it to mean then you think that the U.S. stock market is overvalued?
No, I do not like to generalize the situation. You have to go on ad hoc basis on certain companies. Maybe the stock market, for example, in Saudi Arabia is overpriced, but if you look at certain companies, they may be very fairly priced. Same thing is applicable to the United States. I will not generalize because I don't go into funds, I don't go into hedge funds, I don't go in general terms. I go company specific, like Citigroup, Four Seasons, News Corp, Time Warner, etc.
What about American capital, American business going to the Middle East? Do you think that there's enough flow there now?
That's a more important question. We are now opening up in the Middle East dramatically and substantially. And especially in Saudi Arabia, we're trying to attract foreign investments through through regulations that we have set and established lately. And that's very important because many companies now from the United States and Europe and even Japan are beginning to invest in Saudi Arabia because they are seeing the opportunity, not only in Saudi Arabia, but also in the whole Arab world.
But you have banks like Citigroup obviously selling its stake in Samba, but you have at the same time European and Asian banks moving in. Are U.S. banks missing out? Are they missing a good opportunity?
No, not really, because some banks already took licenses. J.P. Morgan took a license already, and Citigroup already has submitted for license. Some European and Far Eastern banks already have authority and have the approval to operate in Saudi Arabia. So I think that the American companies and banks more specifically have to be more aggressive in looking at our region in a more receptive manner.
Talk to us about Sandy Wild.
You know, Sandy is a friend. Besides the fact that he's a chairman of a company that I own a major stake in and constitutes a very big percentage of my own holdings globally. I have a very good relationship with him, and we talk about many areas. You know, we're not only involved with him into the business area, but also we invest with him in areas that are for the human causes.
There's been talk about Sandy when he steps down. In fact, there was some, you know, last year there was some discussion if he was going to step down before April of next year when he will relinquish his chairmanship and maybe start an equity fund, private equity or investment fund. Is he? And are you going to be invested in it?
Yeah, we read about all this in the newspapers. And now I did not hear anything to that effect from Sandy Weil. And this matter was not covered in my discussion with him.
But would you invest with Sandy Weil if he was going to go invest on his own?
Sure, you have to understand that Sandy Weil is a legend. In the area of business and finance. And whatever Sandy gives me, I'll look at it very seriously. There's no doubt about that. You have to understand that Citigroup, based on Forbes, was the number one global company in the world based on certain criteria, like market cap, revenues, income, etc. So, and this is Sandy's own making. So Sandy Weil is a big force to be reckoned with. There's no doubt about it. Just because he's retiring in April doesn't mean we have to forget his good achievement, not only in banking and finance, but also to the world economies.
Are you going to go into the hotel business maybe with Sandy Weil?
I'm not sure Sandy likes the hotel business. He likes to stay in hotels. I'm not sure he likes to invest in hotels.
Would you be willing to sell some of your hotels but run them?
See, in the hotel industry, there are two parts. There's the management part and there's the real estate part. We are invested, for example, in Four Seasons, in Fairmont and Movenpick. That covers from 4-star to 5 or 6, 7-star portfolios. Also, we're involved in real estate part. For example, George Sang is a unique hotel. This hotel obviously will never, ever sell. And if we have to sell, we'll sell a portion of it, but we always keep majority. Because this, you have to understand, this number one hotel in the world for last 5 years consecutively. And that's a force to be reckoned with. You cannot, if you're going to be in the hotel industry, you have to have a flagship. The flagship is, no doubt, Four Seasons, Fairmont, but the real estate flagship is this one. But like North America, we have, for example, the Plaza Hotel, which we sold and we are investing in right now.
Yeah, you've already made a second reinvestment in,
exactly,
in the Plaza, correct?
On smaller scale.
But companies like Starwood, pretty smart people in their own right, are now divesting themselves of the physical assets, but they're going to run those hotels. Do you want to follow that model? Maybe not for George Sank or your other flagships, but what about the rest of
your company? No problem with that. A perfect example was the Plaza. We entered over there, we sold it at almost 50% return investment, and we are going to re-enter that now at a smaller scale. So yes, we will recycle for sure. Whenever the opportunity comes up, yes, we'll do it. However, there are some strategic investments that we'll never sell.
But you did say that you would never sell Canary Wharf, but you did.
No, I did not. Canary Wharf was never a strategic holding. But I'm telling you right now, on record, Citigroup, Time Warner, News Corp, Four Seasons, George Sank, if we're going to sell, we will sell a minority. If we can ever sell, but never sell the whole thing. These are strategic investors that will go forever.
When Bloomberg's For the Record continues, we're going to ask the Prince why his single biggest stock holding, Citigroup, hasn't done anything in 4 years, and just what he plans to do about it.